Harper Wave and Harper Audio presents Rebuild, 5 proven steps to move from diagnosis to recovery and be healthier than before, by Robert Zembroski, DC, DACNB, MS. Read by Rob Shapiro. A note before we begin. Don't forget to download the accompanying enhancement PDF from your audiobook provider. It contains a health assessment questionnaire, exercises, recipes, and more, and will be referred to throughout as the enhancement. Foreword. I have had the privilege of knowing Dr. Robert Zembroski for the past 8 years, and I have found him to be an inspiration. His successful victory over cancer is only part of his remarkable story. He is a person who walks the talk. Through his expertise and advocacy, he has helped his patients achieve amazing results with improving their health. So this begs a question. What does his book, Rebuild, uniquely offer to the reader? I have reviewed hundreds of health-related books over the past 30 years during my career as a medical researcher, health educator, and opinion leader in nutrition and functional medicine. Most of these books discuss diet and exercise programs to help prevent disease. Dr. Zembroski's book, however, is focused on the description of his tried and proven approach to return to vital health after illness or injury. Dr. Zembroski can speak from experience, not only from his own successful battle with cancer and his path back to optimal health, but also from the clinical application of his program by many patients who have successfully regained their health after illness. Rebuild reads like a manifesto of the remarkable. It demonstrates that miraculous things can happen when a person commits to the right program, designed to return to the best of health and vitality. The use of case histories from Dr. Z's practice provides the connection to reality of the health message delivered in this book. The reader can feel the passion and pursuit of excellence that Dr. Z brings to his practice. He is clearly an expert in translating the science of healing and recovery into a program that can be successfully applied by people seeking to recover their health. As I read the book, I reflected on the conversations I have had with Dr. Z over the years, and I asked myself, what makes certain people special? My answer is that every person is special, but some have had life experiences that bring their specialness to a higher degree of visibility, such as the case with Dr. Z, who has leveraged his own remarkable experience in successfully fighting back from cancer into an opportunity to share what he has learned with others in order to improve their ability to recover good health. The quality that makes Dr. Z special comes through loud and clear in this book. It motivates readers to want to do better, to take charge of their lives, and to commit to something that they may have thought was too difficult before reading this book. It is my belief that the biggest obstacle most people face when making meaningful changes in their health is the inability to see beyond the sacrifice of the required changes to the payoff of improved health and vitality. This is where coaching and a positive support system come into play. Dr. Z has written a book that provides reinforcement and step-by-step encouragement to push through the moments of doubt when a reader may ask, "Is it worth it?" His story demonstrates that yes, it is worth it, and it can happen to anyone following his program with commitment. It has been a great pleasure to get to know Dr. Z over the years. It is hard to know exactly how many people will change their health for the better by following Dr. Z's program. From my years of experience, I expect that the number of success stories will be absolutely transformative. Jeffrey Bland, PhD, FACN, FACB, President and Founder, Personalized Lifestyle Medicine Institute, Seattle, Washington. www.plminstitute.org. Author of The Disease Delusion. Introduction. Recovering from Disease, A New Perspective. Can you recover from heart disease, cancer, diabetes, obesity, autoimmune issues, and other chronic conditions and actually be healthier than you were before you got sick? Can you rebuild your body during a health crisis and then prevent recurrence? Can you melt unwanted toxic fat off your body as you gain lean muscle and restore your health? The answer to all these questions is an emphatic yes. By using the tools in Rebuild, you will come out of your health crisis not only a victor, but also healthier, leaner, and more energetic than you have felt in years. In Rebuild, I explain the link between an unhealthful lifestyle and the creation of disease. I lead you through the steps you must take to rebuild yourself after disease, while you are being treated for a condition, and afterward, to prevent recurrence. You will also learn how to sustain your newfound health for a lifetime and discover the dangers of an unhealthy body composition, the ratio of fat to muscle. An unhealthy body composition is a driving force in the development and return of cancer, heart disease, diabetes, and other chronic ailments. This book presents the latest research in an easy-to-read format so that you can create a lifestyle that will help you not only look great, but also have lots of energy and feel good about yourself. My story. Known to my patients as Dr. Z, I am a physician, specialist in functional medicine, board-certified chiropractic neurologist, clinical nutritionist, and transformational speaker. My clinical practice of 24 years is focused on helping people resolve health issues by finding the root causes of their problems, an approach known as functional medicine. Whether it's hormone-based problems, a chronic disease, neurological problems, or weight issues, I take a functional approach, looking at the whole person, to search for clues. I dig deep for facts that enable me to understand the mechanisms of each issue. That way, I can help you reverse the cause and rebuild yourself back to normal function. I know that what I'm sharing with you works because it has worked for countless patients, and it worked for me. At the age of 38, after a few years of feeling intense stress and neglecting a healthful lifestyle, I was diagnosed with non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, a life-threatening blood cancer. The diagnosis took me by surprise. The first symptoms had been mild. I started losing muscle weight and developed a low-grade fatigue that no amount of caffeine and B vitamins would help. As the symptoms became more severe, including intense head pain and being awakened by gushing night sweats, I knew I was in trouble. I had blood work and x-rays done to find the reasons for my symptoms. On August 18, 2006, a radiologist and friend announced, "You have a 5-inch tumor in your chest." My heart nearly stopped beating, and voices around me sounded muffled. As I walked out of the doctor's office that day, I realized that by not taking care of myself, I had compounded my health problems. Right before I started treatment, the doctors told me, "We're giving you the strongest stuff we have." They were not kidding. Within a 2-year period, I had 7 months of the most toxic chemotherapy, including a chemical similar to mustard gas and a noxious substance known as Red Death, and 4 weeks of radiation. During the first 3 months of chemotherapy, the symptoms and side effects were devastating. I developed the nasty side effects that many people develop. I suffered from peripheral neuropathy, burning and tingling in my fingertips, uncomfortable constipation, burning eyes, and fatigue. My beard stopped growing, my eyebrows fell out, and so did the little bit of hair I had on my head. Hair is overrated anyway. Midway through the chemo cycle, I developed nosebleeds that became a regular occurrence every morning. My left lower leg became very swollen, and the skin surrounding my left ankle turned an amber reddish brown from the drug called Red Death. I also lost all sense of taste, except for the sweet and tangy taste of tomato sauce. Since I'm a foodie, having everything taste like cardboard was a bummer. When I first started chemotherapy, I wasn't told the importance of getting a port put in, a device inserted under the skin where the drugs are infused. As a consequence, the drugs were given to me through a catheter that was pushed into my veins that caused them to flatten and turn brown. On top of that, one of the chemo drugs affected my bladder, delaying the sensation of urgency when I had to urinate. When I finally felt like I had to go, I really had to go. During this period of time, I began wading through research to understand my disease and figure out what I could do to improve my health even during cancer care. The more I learned, the more I applied to myself. As a result, my appetite and strength returned rather quickly and I began to recover. Future scans revealed activity in my chest that I was told was benign. With much excitement, I was back in my practice full-time, working out at the gym, eating well, and now driven to know more about the factors that create disease. As it turned out, I recovered quickly only to find out I was gearing up for round two. Follow-up scans revealed that the lesion in my chest wasn't benign. It was cancer that had not been completely eradicated by the first round of chemo. The excitement that had been building in me was quickly replaced with frustration. I began a second cycle of drugs that were just as toxic as the first, but this time I was armed and ready for battle. I had engineered a rebuild plan to mitigate the side effects of the chemo and keep myself relatively healthy so I could function normally in my practice, work out, socialize, and feel human. Despite the toxicity from the drugs, I continued on my rebuild plan. It was so effective that I was called the freak by my doctors because they couldn't understand how I was doing so well physically and mentally while being treated with the strongest stuff. I was still seeing patients full-time, working out, and living a somewhat normal life during my care. When those treatments were over, the cancer was diminished but not eradicated. At that stage, my prognosis looked grim. In a meeting with my doctors at a well-known cancer hospital, we discussed a stem cell transplant from my brother. The preparation for the transplant involved more chemo to suppress my immune system. As I contemplated the upcoming procedure and its potential health risks, I realized, based on my education and experience, that a stem cell transplant would not work for me. I developed a plan B. I challenged the doctors to remove the tumor, a procedure they claimed never to have done before in cases like mine, but I persisted. 2 years from the day of my diagnosis, a surgeon cracked open my chest from throat to belly and removed the mass of scar tissue where once a giant ball of cancer cells had been growing. That operation, and my persistence, saved my life. However, the cumulative effect of nearly 2 years of chemo, radiation, and major surgery left me with new challenges. Yes, I was cancer-free, but the cancer treatment had taken its toll. Blood work revealed a low red blood cell count, low platelets, and low white blood cells. My thyroid had been affected, which created low levels of thyroid hormones and the symptoms associated with hypothyroidism, including cold hands and feet, slow metabolism, and dry skin. Hormone testing revealed low testosterone and low vitamin D levels. A special test to check my metabolism and energy production revealed that the drugs had also caused malabsorption of B vitamins. On top of discolored skin on my lower left leg from the Red Death and the collapsed veins in my arms, I suffered from weakness in the muscles of my lower left leg, which made fast walking or running a problem. With my health crisis behind me, I asked my providers what I should do to prevent recurrence, and they responded with the sage advice, "Don't eat junk and stay healthy." Wow. That was so profound and helpful. Since my doctors couldn't give me more advice, I knew I had to find the information to help myself going forward. I wanted to learn what had caused my disease so I could prevent its recurrence. I also wanted to learn how to rebuild my body after the side effects of the cancer therapies. My goal was to create the ultimate healthy body, one that was disease-free and lean. I dove into the best research and applied my findings to myself. The facts were there. I had created my own disease. For a few years prior to my diagnosis, I had not taken proper care of myself. Circumstances involving my busy practice, coupled with some standard life problems and setbacks, created extreme levels of stress. This disrupted my sleep and led me to eat unhealthful foods and neglect my exercise regimen. After reading research on nutrition, nutritional biochemistry, genetics, cancer, endocrinology, the study of hormones, chronic disease, and exercise physiology, I refined my program for myself with one thing in mind: to rebuild. In following this plan, I have improved my low blood counts and restored my thyroid, testosterone, and vitamin D levels. My energy is back to normal, and I have no residual tingling in my limbs, a major problem that plagues many people who have received certain chemotherapy drugs. Frantically pulling off the highway at the next exit to empty my bladder is a problem of the past. Although the discolored skin remains, the weakness in my left leg no longer interferes with my physical activity. Currently, I am lean, with 10% body fat. My personal experience, coupled with countless hours of research, ignited a passion.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.